Hi everyone, welcome back to another video, and today we're going to be continuing on with the healer role quest. So we're back in El Amigo, about to speak with the blasphemy hunter in the Butcher's Blade. The struggle to prevent the emergence of beasts grows increasingly desperate. We're hoping you stop by. I show you to Commander Aldin at once. So at least Fodola's going to be in this one. Really looking forward to seeing her again. Welcome sight as always, Claire. Aye, and a lot's happened since last we spoke. We Silver Griffin's been keeping busy. As have I and my men, but I'm afraid we've little to show for our efforts. Although we've been searching high and low for the blasphemy, we've seen neither hide nor hair of it. Unfortunately, everyone else has had better luck. We've received reports of lesser beasts throughout Girobania, and putting them down is as important as hunting the blasphemy that got away. To complicate matters, rumors have been circulating that these beasts were the Skull's kin. While this was true of the recent incidents in Alagana, we cannot have people jump into conclusions, given what they might feel tempted to do. It's been suggested that we take these individuals into custody, for their own protection as much as the safety of others, but that would only isolate them even further and give credence to the rumors. Recent unrest has hindered the efforts of the Silver Griffins to no end. Therefore, I ask that you aid them in their endeavors, and see if there's aught that can be done. Also, you'll be joined by another volunteer. Try not to be too surprised. I thought I felt my ears burning. Well, she just pops right out of existence. I said I don't need a keeper, but did they bloody listen? Did they bollocks? Come now, don't be like that. This is what you agreed to. Besides, you never know when you might have need of a healer, and there's none better than Claire. He's right. You earned a measure of trust, and this shouldn't be taken to mean otherwise. Thick as thieves, are we now? Then there's no need for this sodding collar, aye? We all know it's not coming off anytime soon. If that is how it's to be, then fine, so long as she keeps out of my way. I want the two of you to visit the Silver Griffin's headquarters in Alagana. Several relatives of the Crinae Lupi have agreed to meet with them, and we could do with a measure of precaution. If anyone so much as mentioned the skulls, I'll deal with it, understood? Let's get this over with. She's as much at risk of turning as anyone, maybe even more so. You don't need the Echo to see the weight she's carrying. She's still not got a handle on her own Echo either. Sometimes the visions come without warning, and with such force that it's all she can do to stay standing. There's no telling what might happen when she comes face to face with a family of her former comrades. So look out for her, please. I wish there was more I could do for her myself. But we've all got our own duties, and I'll see them through to the end. So must we all. Follow Fodola's lead. We're counting on you both. But be ready to step in, even if she curses you for it. You know, I think she likes us. I mean, it could have been worse. Definitely could have gone worse. Dola's not the sort to ask for help, so make sure she doesn't get in over her head, aye? Yeah. In case anyone's wondering about that collar reference, it's referring to the choker she's wearing with the red stone. That there is actually an enchanted collar that they put on her to kind of keep her under control, more or less, because if she tries to run away or something, then the collar will continue to grow tighter and tighter until it just chokes her. So she kind of has no choice but to do what they say if she doesn't want to die. I'll admit, this is not quite what I had in mind. I had a feeling Raubon would send for you, Claire. But as for her, if you got any complaints, take it up with the commander. No, it's fine. Truth be told, ever since that day at the Royal Palace, I've been thinking. Stop. You don't want to say it, and I don't want to hear it. To the matter at hand, then. We Silver Griffins have been working to support the relatives of the Cranii Lupi, where one family has gone missing, a mother and her parents, who lived together under the same roof. One of ours paid them a visit, but they were nowhere to be seen, and when they went inside to check, they found the house had been torn to shreds, thick gouges in the floor and the walls, made by the beast's claws by the looks of them. You think they turned? Aye, and that's the most likely explanation. Please do what you must before anyone else is hurt. It's no time to waste. I'll head west, you east. Arnvold tells me she's been trying to make amends in her own way. I appreciate that she's not asking for what I can't give, but I keep thinking to myself, where do we go from here? And I honestly don't know. Yeah, it's very complicated. It really is a complicated thing to have to go through. Wonder if our ghost is happy to actually see something other than the moon. I think we should just summon it out as often as we can. Sense a hostile presence. Ugh. I gotta hand it to them. When they came up with blasphemies, they sure went all out on their designs, didn't they? Like, even like the normal monsters that they come up with are ugly. These guys are like a step above ugly. Crumpled letter. Ooh. A dirty spine envelope containing a crumpled, tear-stained letter. Read the letter? Oh, yes. Dear Mother, I hope this letter finds you well. Time is short, so I must keep this brief. Although I have never done anything to make you proud, I promise you things will be different when the war is over. Until then, take care and know that I love you with all my heart. Placing the letter back into its envelope, you turned your attention to finding the others. Okay. That was a grim... Well, that was depressing. Got another one. Yeah, so there's supposed to be three of them, so we already found two. Chances are the third one already transformed. Anything from this one? Time-worn wedding ring. Discover what appears to be a wedding ring with a name and date engraved on the inside. And with seemingly no more clues to be found, you decide to report to Ragenfeld. That's 2 out of 3, so where's the third one? What's done is done. Were you able to find anything? Yeah, it's kind of sad though. Then it is as we feared. I found and killed a third. It was carrying this. A matching ring. I'll deliver these effects to their next of kin and arrange for a funeral, or as close as one as possible under the circumstances. There's no changing the past. We'll always carry it and the scars. No matter who we were or what we did, we're Alamegans, then and now. The Empire was our enemy then, and now it's despair. Good words and deeds will serve us best in this fight, weapons even an old man like me can yet wield. Thanks to the two of you, the missing villagers may finally be laid to rest. I and the other Silver Griffins will redouble our efforts to prevent any further tragedies. I finished checking the wares, sir. Everything's in order. Good work. Take a rest, lad. You more than earned it. Keep this to yourselves, but Errat's younger brother was a member of the Krennii Lupi. He's exactly the sort of person we're trying to help. Like many of the others, he was reluctant to talk to us at first, but after we gained his trust, we were able to help him find work. He's taken to it well. It's her! Butcher! Oh no. Traitors! All of us Kingslayers deserving of hate and death! Hate and death! Get back! Get back! Oh no. Stay away from her. Fatola saved your girl's life. I know, but she's... It happened in an instant. That poor lad. But it had to be done, and without hesitation. Would have been much worse otherwise. Could you go after Fodola and see to her wounds? I'll do what I can here. Oh man, I mean, didn't the mother see what happened? We're not living a song or fairy tale. These problems we struggle with won't be solved overnight. Nevertheless, we've got to do what we can to move forward as a people united. We'll have to keep dealing with tragedies like this.
I want to say thank you to the brave lady for rescuing me. Do you think I'll see her again?
Yeah, what's with you?
She risked her life to save my daughter. Whatever else she may have done, I owe her for that.
Yeah, so why snap at her like that? Well, what can you do? I don't know. Where'd she go? She couldn't have gotten far. There you are. I'm fine. Leave me be. I said I don't need your help. It's not only your injuries I'm worried about. Bloody hells, if you're here to patch me up, get on with it! Quietly. Coral can't change its spots. There's no washing the blood off my hands. Nor would I, even if I could. Taking out Garley and Steel was the first choice, but not the last. Like the first kill, the hardest. Every choice after that came easier and easier until I stopped counting, stopped caring. You tell yourself it's right, it's for the greater good. You give the order, feel the ground tremble as the cannons fire, and when the dust settles and your own men are buried beneath the rubble, you tell yourself. Oh Me too. Oh no, don't transform, please. Let it take you. That man in the village, I saw his past. I'm the one who killed his brother. I'll be all right. Just need a moment. Can you wait with me? Everything the skulls fought for, the sacrifices we made, the things we did, in the end, it was all for nothing. Sometimes I look back on the road I walked and the bitterness I can still taste, and I wonder, if I had grown up in another time, another place, would I have done the same to a different people? Was it always in me to be me? All I know is everyone would have been better off if I'd never been born. But I was, and I dragged others into a hell of my own making. I remember these two brothers in particular, childhood friends of mine. The older one enlisted with me, but the younger. He would never have made it as a soldier. He was too kind, too good. Ansfrid died at Specula Imperatorius, but his brother's still out there somewhere. Not that I've got the courage to face him after what I did. I hope he's found the life he deserves. Oh yeah, I remember this from a previous quest. Met a former skull called Herdulf. Herdulf? He's alive? But how? glad he made it out. But too many others didn't. Too many others still need our help. I helped make this blast for me, and by Ralgar, I'll kill the bastard if it's the last thing I do. Anyway, that's enough out of me. I'll be heading back to the city to make my report. I suggest you do likewise. Man, that's rough. She definitely feels terrible about all of this, and there's really nothing that you can say to help, because she knows it was wrong, and she's beating herself up about it. And oftentimes, we punish ourselves a lot worse than anyone else could. Okay, but I have a bad feeling about that brother she mentioned. Wouldn't surprise me if he's the blasphemy. But let's go ahead and turn this in. Welcome back. Fedora's already given her account, and I'd like to hear yours too. So she almost turned into a beast herself. We'll have to take that into consideration before sending her into the field again. As far as the events in Aulagana are concerned, the two of you did well. Despite the appearance of several beasts, you were able to prevent any further casualties. However, this serves to confirm that those with connections to the Crania Lupi should be considered at risk of turning. Over the years, many of them have drifted away from the larger settlements and have taken to living in secret. Others make their way to Udall as refugees, including some individuals of interest. As such, we'll be working closely with the Immortal Flames to locate and offer support to those refugees in particular. In fact, I plan to make the journey there for an audience with the Sultana once my preparations are complete. Perhaps you might accompany me. I'm sure she'd be glad to see you. Well, that would be nice to see Nanamo again. Okay, a new battleground. That will be the next one, so we'll leave that right now. So thank you all so much for watching. It was actually a nice little episode, and I like the little bonding experience we had with Fedora. So until next time, everyone, take care, and this is Fantasy Girl signing out.